Winds are now at 70 miles per hour, so just shy of Category 1 hurricane strength. It's picked up its forward speed a little bit, too. It's now moving to north-northeast at 12 miles per hour, heading its way over towards New England. As we get into this afternoon, should continue to intensify up to 80 miles per hour. That would put it as a Category 1 hurricane. As we get into tomorrow, 2 o'clock in the morning, still a Category 1 hurricane before it makes landfall somewhere near Long Island over towards Connecticut, and now then start to dissipate as it works its way out towards the east pretty quickly. So something we'll have to continue to watch for friends up in the northeast. Hurricane Grace just made landfall earlier this morning as a Category 3 hurricane. Now it's starting to slowly weaken. Winds are still at 110 miles per hour, so that is putting some soaking rain over in Mexico. Those flood concerns will remain there throughout the day and into tomorrow. Tropical wave off the coast of Africa, Cabo Verde Islands, starting to slowly trying to develop. 0% chance over the next 2 days, but as we go into early next week, the conditions should improve for some development, and we'll have to keep an eye out as we go into early next week and into mid next week. Right now, closer to home, though, we are dry, just a bit of cloud cover. Temperatures are pretty warm as well. Tower Cam Network showing the moon quite bright over Orlando right now. Beautiful outside. 79 degrees, mostly clear skies. Winds are out of the west at 5 miles per hour, but the humidity is high and it already feels like 83 degrees. Close to the 80s in Leesburg, 79, 76 in the Villages, 76 as well in Ocala. Titusville coming in at 78 degrees, 78 in Melbourne. Right now, Daytona Beach at 78 as well. And as we go over the next 12 hours, all of our temperatures are going to ramp on up. Cloud cover building as we head into the afternoon. About a 50% coverage of rain as we get towards 5 o'clock. That'll slowly start to wash away our heat after reaching daytime highs in the mid to upper 90s, and we'll drop down into the 80s as we head into tonight. So this afternoon, expect the heat just like yesterday. 96 for the high in Leesburg, should hit 94 in Ocala, 95 in the Villages. Even pretty hot along the coastline with that wind from the southwest. Not much of a sea breeze to cool things down, at least not until later on into the afternoon. So Titusville and Melbourne getting up into the low 90s. Palm Coast should get up to about 92 degrees, but with the humidity, pretty much all of us are going to feel like the triple digits at some point this afternoon. Here's 1 o'clock, with most of us feeling right around 101 to 102. So plenty of heat out there. If you are heading out to the beach to try to cool off, with Henri off the coast, we do have a high rip current risk again today until 8 o'clock this evening. So be sure to swim near a lifeguard if you are brave enough to enter the water. If you're not a strong swimmer, I'd avoid it for today. As we go to Futurecast, again, we'll watch just a bit of cloud cover building as we head towards the afternoon. There's noon. Then we'll watch for showers and storms to begin to fire up as we head towards the 3 o'clock hour. That'll continue to spread out by 6 o'clock, expecting the greatest coverage of showers and storms. And that'll start to cool things off for later on this evening. 95 degrees tomorrow, more showers and storms as we continue throughout the week. We'll see a little bit drier conditions by the middle of next week, but highs will remain hot in the low 90s.